Time to put down that big bowl of crazy and instead celebrate with a big bowl of pasta. Today is the day because...
Yes, it's Italian Republic Day and Chef Giovanni Pilou is in studio with us this morning. G'day, mate. How are you?
Hello.
Happy Thursday to you. Happy Italian Republic Day.
Yes.
What does that mean to you?
I don't know. Pasta?
Yeah.
Let's cook some pasta.
Yeah, what are you making? Yeah.
So, vongole and bottarga, which is, I think, Steve, you said that's your signature dish.
It's one of my signatures. I love cooking vongole because...
Spaghetti or tagliolini today, vongole e bottarga.
Vongole e bottarga. Sounds good when you say it.
So, you know what's good? It's a really quick dish. It's good for television.
Let's get going because we don't have a lot of time, apparently, here. So, about 30 grams of salt for 3 litres of water. That's easy to remember. And then I'm just going to drizzle extra virgin olive oil in this pan, which I lightly heat up already. Mm-hmm. And then all we do is a little bit of garlic, freshly sliced. I like to slice my garlic and not chop it too much, otherwise you lose all the oils.
I love watching your knife skills.
Like that. Just lightly cook it. Now, this one here, it's a very, very hot chili. So a few slices of that, not too much. Stevie, if you're cutting this with your fingers at home, just be careful
when
you go to the bathroom.
Don't be fingers in...
Later on.
I said fingers in your eyes and you went straight to the bathroom.
There is some crazy stuff that I've seen. So this is vongole. They come from New Zealand at the moment and I'm just lightly steam them. So you purge them first.
Yeah, so that's just taking the water out of the
sand. You go on and make sure the sand is completely gone.
Okay, I'm just gonna do that. I wonder why my guests always ask why it's so gritty.
That's so they go
in and they literally take about... So I lightly steamed them before, so they're going to cook in about a minute or two, just warm them up a bit.
Oh, wow.
With a lovely garlic and chili. It's called sofrito.
Yeah.
That's what you start normally an Italian dish with, you know, olive oil, garlic, chili, onions, whatever you put, like, you know.
And that's called sofrito.
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 Which is one of the most important...
Base, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
The
okay.
base of your dish, you know, one of the most important things in Italian cuisine. And also it's most important is that you never burn the garlic and the chili, otherwise... That's all you can take.
As an Italian, how do you feel about packet pasta?
Depends what you're cooking with.
Yeah.
Depends on the sauce. Depends on the quality of the pasta, as anything.
Mm.
You know, I think the more money you pay, the better the quality is. Yeah. And for some dishes, you need dry pasta. But in this case, we made tagliolini here.
It's homemade.
I made it this morning. Oh, you made it this morning?
This morning, before I came. As you can tell, look, they're really, really soft and fresh.
Oh.
So just a splash of white wine in there, Steve, and you know that. So make sure that, and that's the good thing about induction, is there is no flame so it doesn't catch on fire, but that's no good either.
It's always a very impressive dish when you have guests over, like a vongole, but the other good thing is that you can spend time talking to the guests because it takes like all of about 3 or 4 minutes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So now let's get going because it's almost like a simultaneously happens.
Do you pop oil in the water for your pasta as well or no?
Sarah, that's a no-go. Absolutely. Don't kill my olive oil in the water.
No, okay, yeah,
Sarah,
just asking.
That's a no-go. Yet, you'll not mess with the Giovanni.
I know. I've been told.
It's crazy.
But just a bit of salt you like, right?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Look, 10 grams of salt per litre of water, okay? That's important that you salt your water so it tastes like the seawater.
Ah.
You know, you've got to be able to... So normally you need 5 litres for a packet of pasta and then you put 50 grams of salt. Just remember that it's... Super important.
Right, okay.
So, fresh pasta takes about 1 minute, and then we're going to finish it off 1 minute in the sauce, which is important that it coats, you know, the whole thing together. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grate a bit of this stuff.
Hang on, what is that?
Oh, this is great.
Bottarga, dried and salted fish roe. So we make this ourselves.
Oh.
It's a very popular in Sardinia, where I come from. So it's grey mullet eggs, and then they just simply salt it and dry it.
Oh, wow.
So this adds a nice little flavour.
Great seafood, fish flavour. So it's like a condiment. And it's great sliced on, you know, bread with butter, or you can grate it on, you know, like buffalo mozzarella with, you know, like a bruschetta or something like that.
Oh, I just love the way you say everything. It's making me hungry.
All right.
You've just come back from Tassie, been preparing for Dark Mofo down there.
Oh,
how's that all looking?
It's coming together. What a place. I love the place.
Is it sensational?
And the guys are, you know, Dark Mofo, they saw ready and excited about this festival that goes on every year. I'm really glad that they invite me because it's going to be amazing. So now, and that's happening in about 2 weeks, everything cooked with charcoal.
Oh.
So we're doing suckling pig with the charcoal and we're doing like a potato bun with it. It's going to be amazing. Yeah.
Great, great. Now, I wanted to ask you quickly, because I always wonder about this when I put my white wine in, when I go and get a cooking wine to throw in.
Yeah.
Should you use, like, a Chardonnay, or is there a particular
Something dry. And it doesn't have to be the best bottle in your cupboard, you know, just something...
Okay, something. Good.
Well, let's plate up, because I know you're dying to taste, Stevie.
Just a bit of parsley there. I like to go by the one in the pot because the stems are quite tender.
Yep.
And they go in as well. They give it a little different texture. So just put some of that in there. Now, if the pasta is drying on me, I've got this water here, which is important to keep some, just to create a little bit of sauce, okay?
This is one of my favourite all-time dishes, I've got to say.
Just like that.
Impressive, tasty...
It's a minute. It's a minute or two, and then just before I serve it, I'm going to put a little bit of olive oil. It's called a crudo, just like that. Oh. And that's it.
Epic. Nice. Okay. If you are in Sydney, make sure you check out Pure Limit Fresh Water. That's where Giovanni. He's going to be cooking up a storm there. Or look out for Giovanni at the Dark Mofo Festival in Tassie this month, as you just heard. He's going to be cooking with charcoal.
Okay, and then what we do, we plate it up here, Sarah, just as simple as that. Just remember, the pasta, it's easy. It's not fussy, okay?
And Giovanni, thank you for coming in. Dig in, Stevie.
Thank you, Giovanni. I'm going to try that.
And a bit of botarga, Stevie.
Go crazy with this. You never have enough botarga,
beautiful stuff.
Grab one of those little clams in there.
Let me know how the chili is. Should be just...
Breaking news, he loves it, Miss Tash.
That is
perfect.
Very, very good.
It's just perfect.